स्टेंसा 73 दिस वन आई ऑलवेज कोट व्हेन आई गिव टॉक अन्या हि लाभोपनिषा अन्या निब्बाणगामिनी of the Buddha should not rejoice in worldly favors but cultivate detachment. This understanding is very important for us because religious way of life or the spiritual development or worldly life or worldly pleasures or worldly gains, they belong to two different section or path, two different path. By working for worldly gain, worldly pleasure, it is impossible for us to cultivate our spiritual way of life or the peace and happiness and satisfaction in our life. We will never gain it. Then, to gain freedom, peace, happiness, satisfaction, or salvation, we have to curtail or reduce step by step, slowly, 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 we have to reduce. To have free mind without too much bondages, too much commitment, too much responsibilities and crazy attitude toward the pleasure, we have to reduce. If you do not reduce, forever we remain in the worldly side, mundane side, and never get into the other side, supramundane or the spiritual development. But what is happening today, all the existing religions mix up both and very difficult for them to getting to the other path for the spiritual development. Too much involvement, commitment with worldly commitments, because of desire, craving, attachment and pleasure. But these things in the end create disappointment, frustration, calamities, disturbances, any kind of worldly pleasure will be ended with unhappiness. But the spiritual development, when you continue step by step, never create any disappointment, no disturbances, no unhappiness, no unsatisfactoriness, no external disturbances. Two different things. Since we are bound to this worldly life, it is very difficult for us to get rid of them, because we always think they are very important for us. We need them, because these things give emotional satisfaction. We indulge or we entertain our human emotion. But the spiritual development is not for this emotional satisfaction. That is why those who are very particular about their spiritual development keep away even from dancing, singing and merrymaking and all sort of entertainment, because these things arouse the emotion. It is not that religion is against these things, but religion points out these things arouse our emotion. Then we forget our development of our knowledge, our wisdom, our purity and spiritual way of life because of the emotional satisfaction. Take for instance, when there are certain performances, entertainment, amusement. At the same time we organize a meditation class or religious talk or chanting class here. But how many people come and join with this group, and how many people go there and enjoy entertainment? That is natural. We cannot blame them. That is natural. So the spiritual development means by realizing that these entertainments are means to an end. That means for a short while we gain some sort of thrill or some sort of excitement, laugh. After that, nothing. Like a dream. Exactly like a dream. We experience wonderful dreams at night. But the morning when you get up, there is nothing. So all these entertainments are exactly like a dream. But when we develop spiritual development, that is not means to an end. The continuity or the peace and satisfaction or calmness or understanding that we developed in our mind support us to continue, develop further and further, but not means to an end. Again, now we like to be rich, make money, property. Yes, for worldly life they are important. Buddha also advised, yes, you must have something. But because of these things, can you imagine amount of worries, fear, disturbances, suspicion, again enemies, thieves? How many evil forces are there around these things? Because of your money, because of your property. If one day, when you are free from all these things, no enemies, no evil forces around you, you are free, then you have more chance to contemplate peacefully without any external obstructions or hindrances or difficulties. Nobody wants to disturb. The more you develop your worldly life, your worldly powers, then not only your property, your life also in danger. And every day we can see in the newspaper, oh, so and so was shot dead, either prime minister or presidents or the kings or the rulers or the ministers or if not multimillionaires. That is the uncertainty of worldly development. Even today's newspaper, somebody was contesting for presidentship or something like that, shot dead, finished. Those who work to gain more authority, more power, have to face this. And those who want to make more money, more rich, to enjoy more also, so many disturbances and enemies and jealousy, uncertainty, no peace. By realizing this, here the Buddha says, Anya hi labhopanisa, anya nibbanagami. One method or one way for you to develop your worldly life, material, mundane, for worldly enjoyment. One method, yes. But when you go through this method, by working, earning, enjoying, there will be so many enemies, so many disturbances, and then insecurity, feeling, excitement and fear. All these problems we have to face every day because of our worldly development. Again, when you develop our way of life, climb up to the maximum level in the society as leaders, then what will happen? Everybody is watching to find out loopholes and weaknesses. This you can understand. When a man climbs a hill, he is going higher and higher and higher and climbing, climbing, climbing. You can see only his backside. This is a very good example. If anybody climbs in the society or in the political field or any other field, climb up to the maximum level, everybody is watching to see the weaknesses, loopholes, mistakes. Then start to criticize and condemn and accuse and publish in the newspapers. This is the nature. So, when you develop this worldly life in this way, everybody is watching, either to grasp or to bluff or to signal or to take by force, if not attack or criticize or condemn or to kill. Worldly development, all these problems. So in spite of all these problems and worries and fear and disturbances, we also never give up. We have so many security guard and guns and this and that and bodyguard, and even then life is not safe. But when we develop spiritual way of life, nobody want to disturb, accuse or blame or take the advantage, but people support. A king, after ruling for a certain period, especially bodhisattvas, during many previous births, when he was ruling the country as king, after middle age, he decided, time has come for me to retire. I must hand over this to either my brothers or sons or anybody who is entitled. Hand over, then he goes away. Now he has no bodyguard. No, he can go anywhere wherever he like. He can eat anything whatever he like. But those days he was like a prison, real prison. No freedom at all. So he goes out sometimes, sit down under a tree. Then he say, "Aho Sukham, Aho Sukham. What a wonderful happiness I am experiencing now. Formerly I was a prisoner. Now I have no fear in my heart. I know nobody want to kill me or kidnap me or disturb me. I am a free man." But we cannot experience that happiness by holding some sort of property or any worldly, mundane, material things. But they are important for our worldly life, to fulfill our commitment and responsibilities and obligations. They are important if you want to lead a worldly life. But by leading a worldly life, enormous problems and worries and disturbances that we have to face every day. Can you find a single contented or happy man amongst all those things? Because they are in fear. You know, there are so many enemies. It is not that he creates enemies purposely. This is, although we cannot adapt at once this way of life, this understanding must be there in our mind. We should not become slaves to our property, our money, our income, or our worldly life, because these things create enormous problems. As you, we could manage to lead our life without facing so many problems with a very big property. Now we have strong attachments and craving for our property. Then what will happen to us if we die with a strong craving towards our property? What will happen? Life become unfortunate. Because of that craving, after death, they do not go away from this property. They will be somewhere around, become some sort of spirit or ghost or some sort of unfortunate living being. Craving is mental pollution. Because of that mental pollution, rebirth takes place as one of these spirit or ghost or something. There are millions of cases to prove what happened to them. Therefore, we have to organize our way of life systematically, not to continue our strong craving attachment towards our property. Go on reducing, doesn't mean throwing away. Hand over to the children or those who are entitled to receive. If not, donate certain charitable organizations, hospital, orphanages, temples, social welfare work, then you can reduce. Then the mind becomes free. Of course, there are some silly ideas in some people's mind. If they die as very rich people, there will be very good reputation. He died as a multimillionaire. That is a silly idea. We cannot glorify that. If we can die as a penniless man, then we have more opportunities and facilities and privileges to have better life in the next world. Penniless means the things that we have donated, we have handed over, we have reduced our responsibilities or the commitments or attachment. Release these things from the mind. They are not in our mind now. After middle age, we had to reduce our too much of enjoyment. It is childish if people try to enjoy too much after middle age, because that is the time that they can devote to use their knowledge and wisdoms and maturity and experience and understanding. So many things to guide others, to teach others. They should not devote their time all the while enjoying after middle age. When they were young, they enjoyed already. They have seen the world. But when they think how they enjoy, it's like a dream, nothing. There's nothing to satisfy thinking how they enjoy. They spend that period to do some service by using that knowledge and experience and maturity. Then they have more discipline, not to become crazy, become slaves to enjoyment. Must maintain some sort of dignity, human dignity, during that period. And then others respect it. Then when you grow old, nearer to our grave, step by step, every day, marching towards a grave. Yes, we know this very well. We have to prepare for that. Not simply by worrying and crying and lamenting and creating unsatisfactoriness. Prepare to face fact in our life. That is called understanding of the life. Then the mind must be free. Reduce. So many commitments and responsibilities about the business and the income and property and handover. Have free mind. Recall all the good deeds that you have done during your lifetime. Then you gain happiness, happiness, happiness. Don't think all the bad deeds you have done. Don't recall it to your mind. All the good deeds. Because we are preparing for the next life now. We know this is, our death is not the end of our life. Then we must be wise. What have we done? What have we prepared for the next life? If this is not the end, how did we prepare to face our life? Only human beings can do that, but not others. Then, the mind is free. That person is not scared of death. For what purpose? People don't like to die due to various reasons. It is not that they are scared of death. Think of their property. And then how to die? There is so much in the bank, so many houses, so many things. How to die? And then worry and worry and fear disturbances. That is why it is necessary to free our mind from all these things when come to that age. Again, children, wife, husband, houses, how to die? Some people say, my wife is still young, you know how to die? I heard somebody was telling me. So until my wife become old, you know, I cannot die. See, what sort of ideas people have. We have to reduce by fulfilling all the duties and responsibilities towards them, not to suffer. And then they will respect them more. After that, as mentioned in the Buddha's teaching, that amongst four kinds of happiness that we experience during our lifetime, the last one, anavajya sukha. When we think of our past experience, how we lived, how we used our life, anavajya sukha. If our mind knows that we have not done any harm to anyone, that happiness is the highest happiness in our life. Because this happiness gives confidence. Confidence for us to lead this life without worrying and worrying. No worries, no fear. Again, confidence, hopes and confidence by knowing next life never become miserable. Because we have not done any harm to anybody. So we have to prepare our life. The dying moment in one mind decide. Others cannot decide for us. God cannot decide. The Buddha cannot decide. Our family members cannot decide about our future life. My way of thinking, what I have done during my lifetime, these things are responsible for my next life. Just only namesake, or say, you believe in God, He will take you to heaven and finish. So easy. when you are committing all the evil deed, bad deed, God is not there to come and stop you, allow you to do any kind of dirty and cruel thing. When you are going to die, you say, oh, I believe in God, He come and save you. And who is going to save the victims that you have disturbed? Nobody. God is not there to save the victims. What sort of justification is there? There's nobody. Your mind, our mind. That is why it is necessary for us to maintain some sort of purity without developing a guilty feeling in our mind. Then the fear always disturbs the mind. If guilty feeling is there, oh, I have done this, I have done this, I have done all these dirty, wicked, cruel things, then guilty feeling disturbs the mind, then the next life also becomes very unfortunate. So, when we are going to develop our worldly life, you know the amount of bad deeds, amount of bad karmas, amount of disturbances that we create? Can you imagine? Assume you are going to do some business. Every day you have to tell lies to do your business to gain more income. Otherwise it is not business. This is the nature of worldly life. So whatever you do as worldly thing for you to gain some sort of income or to gain some sort of pleasure, you had to make enormous mistakes and bad things. Otherwise you cannot do your work. Sambadhoyam gharavaso, household life, worldly life, mundane life, create enormous sambada, hindrances, obstruction, disturbances in our life. Otherwise you cannot carry on your worldly life. There are many things you have to do which you don't like. You know these things are wrong, against your religion, but you have to do this. This is the nature of worldly life. You know very well, killing of any living being is wrong from the Buddhist point of view. But you cannot escape from this. You know telling lies also wrong. Like every day you have to tell lies. You know swindling, bluffing others also wrong, but every day you are doing something. This is the nature of worldly life. So when you keep away from all these things, you are free. You never commit any bad thing. No need to tell lies. And anger, jealousy, ill will, enmity also never appear in the mind. No reason. Because we create all these things in our mind because of worldly, material gain, thinking that we may lose something or we cannot gain something, then we become jealousy, then develop grudge, then enmity, then accuse, blaming, shouting. How many kinds of bad karmas committed because of that? No, it is not so easy. When we analyze, observe very carefully, the nature of worldly life, full of dirt, full of wicked things, full of monkey tricks. Worldly life is like that. Otherwise, no place. So, the meaning of renunciation, the real renunciation, by realizing this, संबाधोयं घरावासो दिस वर्ल्डली लाइफ क्रिएट एनोमस मिस्टेक पेव द वे फॉर अस टू क्रिएट मिस्टेक पर्सुएट अस टू डू मिस्टेक कैनॉट एस्केप. Now you always ask, how can we live without killing mosquitoes, ants, cockroaches, lizards, snakes? Yes, white ants, especially white ants. How can we live without destroying them? Now can you say, no harm? We can destroy them. Can you say from the Buddhist point of view? Cannot. This is more than enough for you to understand difficulty that we had to face if we want to lead a worldly life. Certain things we know they are wrong, but we had to do them. Can we say there won't be any bad effect? No, we cannot see, because we have done deliberately, intentionally, for our living, for our pleasure. We have to do all these things. But when renounce all these things, nothing. Sambadoyam gharavaso rajas ayatanam iti. Rajas means dirt. That is the fountain for dirt. Always dirty things come out from this worldly life. Abhokaso pabbadyam. Renunciation is just like flying in the sky. The birds that fly never carry anything. No suitcase, no property, no money, no medicines, nothing. Only two wings. They migrate from country to country. No passport also. They are free. Fish also migrate from country to country. To lay eggs, I heard certain fish, you know, travel from one country to another country, lay eggs. See how clever they are. So, when we reduce our burdens, we can avoid so many bad commitments, evil deeds. When we have more responsibilities, more commitments, more duties, then we have to do more and more evil deeds, bad deeds, and mistake, and disturb others. Here, anyahi labhopanisa. Labh means gaining, gain. For gaining, for worldly pleasures, there is one method. By following this method, you never gain nibbana bliss or salvation or freedom or liberation or satisfaction in your life. You never gain. But throughout your life, you had to grumble, you had to cry, you had to worry, you had to fight, you had to get angry, you had to develop jealousy, you had to do all the bad things if you go on developing this worldly life. This is the nature. It is true. No one denies that. But by realizing this, when you reduce so many unnecessary burdens, disturbances, responsibilities, then mind becomes free from all these disturbances. Then you have more chance to cultivate your mind, your life, your understanding. Then there is no ground, or there are no reasons for you to harbor so many evil forces in your mind. Now we try to avoid from evil forces, evil thoughts. We try to avoid. But the circumstances never allow us to do that. Because of this worldly thing. They irritate us, then create anger. They disturb our mind, then create jealousy. They stir our mind, then we cannot control it, then we develop some sort of enmity, develop hatred, polluted. The purity of the mind is gone, no more. What are the causes? All these worldly things. If these things are no more, the mind gets the chance to relax and not to harbor such evil thoughts. Now you are very quiet, sitting here with smiling face, very calm, very serene. After 1 or 2 hours time when you go home, how do you behave? Shouting and accusing and fighting and quarreling and cursing and being, because of your property. All these disturbances, now you have no property here. So your mind is very calm and very serene, so nice. As soon as you enter into your house, why this one is there? Who asked you to keep you there? I asked you not to keep this one here. I start the fight. Then go to kitchen. All sort of disturbances. Then beat the children, accuse them and the servants. Then start. No peace. That is worldly life. You can escape from this. Anya Nibbana Gami. Path towards Nibbana. Nibbana means freedom. It's another. Don't mix up with your worldly material things. Then why it is necessary for us to find out this freedom? Every existing religion in this world talk about salvation. This is salvation. Why it is necessary to have salvation? Why cannot live here forever? They too admit any religion. Here in this mundane worldly, by leading a worldly life, no one can gain salvation or freedom. Experience salvation and freedom. Now that is why people say the aims of all these religions is the same. That means attain freedom or salvation. Then they have introduce or adapted different method or belief or practice to achieve, to gain that salvation. And some people believe only by praying and worshipping and belief in God, they can find out salvation. Some others say, primitive people started, they had no idea of God at that time. They say by performing rites and rituals and ceremonies and burnings and this and that, they can find out their salvation. Second method. Some others say this is also started by primitive people. By torturing, burning, cutting, starving, they can wash away all the sins committed by them. And after that, salvation. So the Buddha did not agree any of these methods. He never said, by worshipping, praying to any god, you can find your salvation. He never said. By performing any kind of rites and rituals and ceremonies, you cannot find out your salvation. Because of this. Then what is the Buddhist method? Here. You must know what is the worldly life and what is the life that we have to lead to gain freedom and salvation or liberation or nirvana. Then what is the method introduced by him for us to gain that? This worshipping, praying, offering, rites and rituals and all these things we have learned from all the other religions. The Buddha has never introduced any of these methods. He never talked anything about all these practices. He was not interested. So we learn all these methods from the existing religions at that time, even today. One religion borrows from another religion. The method introduced by the Buddha is lead harmless and useful life. Remember. Harmless and useful life. Harmless means observing precept, 5 precept, 8 precept, 10 precept, that then become harmless life. Useful life means by doing some service to others to release their sufferings, cultivate kindness, compassion, unity and harmony, understanding, all the good qualities. Useful life. Two methods. That means not to do certain things and to do certain things. Then we must know what are the things that we should not do and what are the things that we have to do. Then think about your mind, whether your mind, in your mind, still you maintain these impurities, defilement, or evil thoughts. They are hidden, cannot see. Not noticeable, then they are normal. Submerge. Sleeping. Because when we keep away from bad things, when you do good things, evil forces go on down and down and down and settle down and sleep. That means minds are not pure yet. Any moment, environment, temptation, irritation can stir the mind and all those sleeping cobras come up. Now we are very good. All of us are very good. Now we have no anger in our mind. We have no jealousy in our mind. We have no enemies here. Yes, they are sleeping. If anybody say something, do something to irritate,
flare up. That is the uncertainty. So although we keep away from bad things, do good things, we can say, oh, we are safe, we are, now there is a guarantee. No, there is no guarantee. Evil forces are there inside. Then introspect means must try to understand awareness of our thoughts. What sort of thoughts appear influenced by those hiding evil forces? Then try to reduce them one by one. Concentration, contemplation, or meditation, and observing, analyzing, studying, there are so many methods. Then we can understand what to do with these bad thoughts and evil thoughts and bad habits. Not simply by meditating also. We have to observe things very carefully, what is happening all around. What happened to so-and-so, why so-and-so is like this, why so-and-so is suffering, why so-and-so is happy, why so-and-so is angry. Observe, find out why. Then we get the answer. Then contemplate means we take one particular object into our mind, then go on contemplating this, so that the mind get used to it. I have told you the five method introduced by the Buddha for us to contemplate, always contemplate. Then your mind will be free from the fear, worries, disturbances that create because of this. What are those things? Jara dhammo mijarang anati toti. I am not free from old age. I am reaching old age. Contemplate. Go on. When you are young, we have to contemplate on this. Because you don't like that. Then mind get used to it. One day when you come to know you are getting old, you never worry. No fear. Because you trained your mind to know that you have to face this. That worry no more. When you grow old, you never worry about the old age. Sicknesses, any kind of sicknesses can come to us any time. We are not free from it. Physical body is not holy. The Buddha's physical body was not holy. He had to suffer so many kinds of sicknesses. The Buddha is not in the physical body. Contemplate about the physical body, subjected to any kind of sicknesses. But one day when one of those sicknesses come to us, whether it is cancer or this or that, yes, we know that. One of these things definitely come to us. Mind is used to it. Worry, fear, never appear at that time. Marana dhammo mi maranam ananti. One day I had to face death. It is natural. If death never come to me, then life become real nuisance to me. Death must come. What are we going to do with this body if there is no death? We do not know what to do with this life if there is no death. Become real nuisance. Death must come. Then start another new one later. the fear disappear when you contemplate on this, yes, death will come to me only. I am ready to face it. I cannot hide it. There is no place to hide. Contemplate. Then, sabbehi me pehi mana pehi nana bhava. All my beloved, my wife, my husband, my children, my property, my jewelry, my money, all these things, definitely have to separate from you. Departure is natural. If not earlier, after death, separated. Earlier, fire, water, white hand, thieves, or bluffing and swindling. If not death, separate. Because of our attachment toward this thing, then we cry, we worry, we lament, we get heart attack, all sort of thing. I remember a small boy, I think about 10 years old, small boy here in KL. After Chinese New Year, some gangsters enter into their house. And by force, taking daggers and all those things, taken away jewelry and all sort of things, and red packet received by this boy also on the table. And this red packet also taken away by these gangsters. Then, when some friends or relatives visited the house, the father told, this poor boy's red packets also taken away those people. You know what this small boy said? Why worry? This is not our money. This money given to us by others. Why worry about that? See that small boy's way of thinking. We had to develop our thinking up to that level. Money comes to our hand from another person. We don't produce money. It is quite possible this money can go to another person's from my hand. That is the nature of the money. Money is like that. That small child had the mind to think in this way. This is not my money. Taken, given to us by others, then some others have taken it. So all our property that we cling and we crave, we had to develop our understanding up to that level. Suddenly you are taken away by others, stolen by others, burned by the fire. We did not come to this world with all these properties. We did not come to this world even with a piece of cloth, fully naked. But we earned. And this may go to another, somebody else's hand, good nature. That is the development of this understanding. Then, kammasa komi kamma dayado kamma yoni kamma bandhu. My own karma is responsible for me. There's nobody else to take the responsibility of my life. The belief that people maintain God and Buddha and Bodhisattvas are all our imagination. We create this imagination. But the real truth is, my own action, my own karma is responsible for my life. This life and the next life. It becomes either miserable or pleasurable, fortunate or unfortunate, according to my own karma. Therefore, I must be wise. Reduce as much as possible bad karmas. Do as much as possible good karmas. Because these karmas will support me, assist me in my life. I have to depend on my own karma. So when we contemplate in this way, what a knowledge, understanding, satisfaction we need. And then we pave the way for the spiritual development. We are not crazy for all these things which are impermanent, changeable. So, in this sense, anya hi labho panisa anya nibbana. For worldly life, there is one method. For freedom and spiritual development is another method. When we work with worldly life, we have to face enormous troubles and problems and worries and disturbances. When we work through the spiritual development, more calmness, more happiness, more satisfaction, more peaceful life. These are the differences. Yes.